My dad lost a son who would have been my older brother, and his lungs didn't develop, and he died in the hospital as an infant. My dad and his wife at the time had a lot of well-intentioned people say things that were not very helpful for them emotionally with what they were going through after that devastating loss. They told them, "Be grateful that you're young, you can have other children." They told them, "You mustn't be mad with God." They repainted the nursery white and moved out all the furniture to pretend that nothing had happened. These were the tools that they had in the late 70s. Unfortunately, these are the tools we have in 2021. Grief and loss is a topic that no one likes to talk about. We avoid people at the supermarket instead of asking them how they're doing. People compare losses, they minimize, they judge, and they tell us when we should be better. The pain of that loss for my father was unbearable for him. He nearly took his own life because of it. He found, through searching and through self-reflection, he found tools that helped him, actions that he could take to get complete emotionally with all the hopes and dreams and expectations that weren't going to be met because he lost that son. People kept sending him other people who were grieving losses, and he shared these tools and these actions with them. His intuition told him to write a book, and he did in the spare bedroom of his apartment. He wrote the Grief Recovery Handbook. He put all of these actions in a sequence that could help others. HarperCollins and some other publishers got word of this book, and HarperCollins published it, and it's been a large seller ever since in all the major bookstores, Amazon, and all of that. From that book came the Grief Recovery Institute, and from that book came the 8-week group program locally, and the 2.5-day personal workshop, and the 4-day certification training to train others to help people. Over 40 years later, we're helping more people than we ever have before. Growing up, I thought it was always a noble cause that my dad had. At that time, I didn't have a lot of grief in my life. At 6, I told people my dad helped sad people. That was my awareness of what the grief recovery method was at that time. My dad helped sad people. In my 20s, I was in a completely different career, and grief started entering my heart. I lost a dear friend in a drunk driving accident. I had been through multiple breakups. I had blown out my knee, ending a lifelong dream of playing in the major leagues in baseball. I had a cousin who took his life, and on, and grief started accumulating in my heart, and now I needed the grief recovery method. I signed up for a 4-day certification training weekend, and I went through the grief recovery method, and it changed my life forever. I did work that I had been needing to do for a long time. By the end of that 4 days, I was discussing coming on board full time, and I asked my dad for a job because I felt like it was that important. I ended my 7-year-long career in another industry, and I dedicated my life to grief recovery after I saw the power of it. That was 10 years ago. There's not a day that goes by that I'm not grateful that I made that decision, both for myself personally and for all of the people that I have had the honor to work alongside and share tools and create a safe environment for them to go do the work that they wanted to do, that they were never taught how to do. Society doesn't give us any tools around grief and loss. We have tools. We've helped hundreds of thousands of people. The book now is in over 20 languages. We have offices on almost every continent on the earth now. We know exactly how to truly help you with the unique relationship that you are grieving. We will never say that we know how you feel, but we'll tell you how we felt after our loss, and we'll tell you more importantly the actions that we took to get emotionally complete with what was unfinished in that relationship. We won't forget about the person. We won't lose memories of them, but we will help you complete the pain connected with that loss, the unfinished, painful emotions. We want you to keep all of the good memories. We want you to be able to check in with them emotionally as they enter your heart. We want you to have any spiritual beliefs that you bring, and we want those to be stronger when you leave than when you came. None of these are promises. These are things we do on a daily basis with fellow human beings. And it would be our honor to work with you. Thank you. I love you. And I hope to meet you.